to hear the words from the Holy Scriptures, the plan of love and salvation God had for us from the beginning. And I'm very blessed to be able to work with Florida Cantores from a variety of our churches in the diocese, and the Christ Episcopal Church Carol Choir, led by Susie Fergus. And we have members from the Santo Niño de Cebu Filipino Choir, and friends from Cathedral and Chapel together. Let's begin with our processional, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus.
The man replied, here with me. She gave me fruit from the tree, so I ate it. The Lord God asked the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman answered, "The snake tricked me, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the snake, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all the animals, tame or wild. On your belly you shall crawl, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. They will strike at your head, while you strike at their heel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. my strength and my might, and he has been my salvation. With joy you shall draw water from the fountains of salvation. And you will say on that day, give thanks to the Lord, acclaim his name. Among the nations, make known his name. Proclaim how exalted he is. Sing praise to the Lord, for he has done glorious things. Let this be known throughout the earth. Shout with exultation, city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lord, we wait for the day of your peace. May we help to bring this peace in our families, our communities, and our world. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The grass withers, the flower wilts, but the word of our God stands forever. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of good news. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Cry out, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom, leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Stand. God, you are always with us. May we always trust in your presence and share it with those around us. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord shall judge the poor with justice and decide fairly for the lands afflicted. He shall strike the ruthless with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Then the wolf shall be a guest of the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat. The calf and the young lion shall browse together, while a little child to guide them. The cow and the bear shall graze, together their young shall lie down. The lion shall eat hay like the ox. The baby shall play by the viper's den, and the child lay his hand on the adder's lyre. They shall not harm or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be filled with knowledge of the Lord as the water covers the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God. Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went out to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. The word of the Lord.
Please stand. Lord, you are the giver of all good gifts. May we always remember to share our gifts with others for the glory of your name.
Now there were shepherds in their region, living in the field and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go then to Bethlehem to see the thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the infant lying in the manger. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Life, and this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him, but the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by a man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we saw his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Please stand. Lord, you call us to be your witnesses to the ends of the earth. Fill our words with power that we may proclaim your good news and draw all people to you. Amen. Let me begin by first thanking Suzanne Lyles and all these wonderful people who have practiced, and Julianne and everyone else who does such a wonderful job in pulling this together. What takes an hour to present to us takes hours and hours and hours of work. And I also want to thank all of you for being here as well. We are blessed to be here in the Cathedral Parish, where we have all these opportunities to gather, especially gather this afternoon for these lessons and carols. A beautiful Advent service combining readings from Scripture, focusing on the prophecy of the birth of Christ, and singing of hymns. And in our Catholic tradition, this is such a beautiful way, really, to prepare for and to celebrate the Advent season, leading up, of course, to Christmas, which will be here before we all know it, right? It's good to take some time away from all the things going on to just focus on Advent. In our readings this afternoon, we heard the themes of hope, anticipation, joy, and, of course, the coming of Christ. I hope that you're able to use this time this evening for reflection, for a little meditation, for a little prayer, and I invite you to really think about the profound mystery of the Incarnation, the moment when God became human in the person of Jesus Christ, the light of the world. Amongst all the things going on this time of year, I hope your time here this afternoon inspires you to really remember the true meaning of Christmas and to approach the season with a heart full of gratitude and reverence for the true gift of Christ's coming into the world. May God bless you all.
Thank you.
Judah and Jerusalem, fear not, nor be dismayed. The war will go forth, and the Lord will be with you. Stand still, and you shall see the salvation of the Lord. Tomorrow go forth, and the Lord will be with you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
And may Almighty God.